Welcome to GrayYeon. If you ask to solve this problem, we have a square and inside the square, a lavender area. 25% of the square, it has dimensions 4 and 8. And we are required to find the isosceles triangle area, the blue area. But before we go to the solution, may I request you to please like this video and subscribe to the channel. You can post your model so you can write a solution for this problem in the comment section. Okay, so first thing that we need to do is we need to label the angles. So if we label this angle, isosceles angle to be A. And this should also be A. And since this is from a square, then we name or label the complementary angle as B. And we say that A plus B equal to 9. So if this is B, then if we draw this red line here and then we say that this is B and this is 90 degree angle. This is also 90 degree angle. So this is B and this is A. And since this is A, this is B. And since this is A, this is 90 and this is A. And next is we draw a vertical line from this point. Then if that is A, then this is B. And this is 90. And since A plus B is equal to 90, then this angle should be 90. And this should be also 90. So if that is angle B, then this should be B. Then by exterior angle theorem, this angle here should be 2B. And if that is 2B, then this angle should be 90 minus 2B. And if that is 90 minus 2B, then this should be 2B. And if we draw a line from this topmost point to the triangle in the base, and since this is an isosceles triangle, then we can divide this 2b into two parts, two equal parts. That is b and this is b. Okay, so to find the area, easiest thing to do is we need to find the base, this isosceles triangle, and the height, which is this distance, the broken line. So 1/2 times the base bar side would be the area of that isosceles triangle. Okay, so to find h, h should be this vertical distance of this isosceles triangle. So that would be 8 times cosine of B, and this distance that is 1/2 B, one for this broccoli sine B. Okay, so next thing that we need to find out are the values of the hypotenuse, cosine of the angle B, and the sine of angle B. So for the hypotenuse, we have hypotenuse is equal to the square root of 4 square plus 8 square, and that is equal to the square root of 16 plus 64, and that would be 80. And 80 can be written as the square root of 16 times 5, and that is to be simplified as 4 square root of 5. That is the hypotenuse. Then for cosine of B, then that is equal to the adjacent side over the hypotenuse. So the adjacent side of this angle is 8 over 4 square root of 5, which is the hypotenuse. So if we rationalize that, then we have 8 square root of 5 all over 4 times 5, which is 20. And if we simplify further, we have to divide this by 4. So we have 2 over 5. So cosine of beta equal to 2 square root of 5 over 5. And for the sine of beta, then we have opposite side. Opposite over hypotenuse. So the opposite side is 4 over 4 square root of 5. Or we can cancel the 4. And next is we rationalize that. Then we have 4 square root of 5 over 5. And this is sine of the angle B. Okay, so next thing is we need to find the values of the base, the height. And if we are to find the value of the base, that is 1 half B is equal to 8 sine of the angle B. So B is equal to 2 times 8 times sine angle B. B is equal to 16 times sine of B. B is equal to 16 times square root of 5. And that is B is equal to 16 square root of 5 over 5. And for the value of H, we have 8 times cosine of the angle B. That is equal to 8 times 2 square root of 5 over 5. That is 16 square root of 5 over 5. Okay, so for the final step is we can now find the area. But the area is equal to 1 half times the base times the height. The area is equal to 1 half times the base, which is 16 square root of 5 over 5 times the height, which is 16 square root of 5 over 5. And we can cancel this out. And this also 16 divided by 2 is equal to 8. 8 times 16 is equal to 128 all over 5 square units. And that is our answer. Please write in the comment section below if you have any other solutions about this problem. Thank you for watching until the end of the video. Please like the video if you like our solution, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you will be updated for more math videos like this. Thank you. Bye.